Hey guys, what's up? So in this lesson, I'll be teaching you how to write a CV. This is presented by me, Rishav Rivude. And guys, if you feel that these courses are helping you in any way, do encourage me by giving me a thumbs up. So this is a bit about me. You can read it here. So let's begin. So these three terms, CV, resume, and biodata. We come across these terms almost every day in our day-to-day lives, okay? And these three terms are often used interchangeably, okay? Means ek ke jagah pe dusra use ho jata hai, okay? But please pay attention when I tell you that these three terms are very different in their meaning as well as in their applications, okay? So what is resume, my friends? Resume is a French word that means summary, and hence is a summary of one's education, skills, and employment details. Okay, it lists only the specific skills customized for a target job. Okay, so this is the key word here, target job. Okay, so it does not have other irrelevant details. Okay, and it is written in third person. This increases the professional output of a resume by writing it in third person. So how a resume basically is written? It starts with a brief profile of the applicant. Okay. It is followed by the recent educational pursuit as well as the employment details, and then is followed by the summary of previous experiences, both education wise and job wise. Okay, and please remember this important point, that skills that you mention in a resume are more important than your educational qualifications. Okay, so this is all about resume. So let's move ahead to CV. So CV stands for curriculum vitae. Okay, it is a Latin word that means the course of life. Okay, it is detailed and longer than the resume. Why? Because it includes all the highlights of all the general talents of the applicant. So it can be used by fresh graduates to apply anywhere. So my dear friends who have just graduated, okay, so you can apply using a CV to good companies like TCS or Wipro. Okay, so I have specifically made this lesson keeping this in mind. Okay, so now what is a biodata? So see, the biodata focuses only on the personal particulars, okay, and it is the chronological educational detail and the experiences in a particular sequence. Okay, so it states the educational details and the experiences of the applicant. So where is it used? It is used generally for government jobs as well as for submitting descriptive essays for research grants for all my friends who will do PhD. Okay, so before we start writing a CV, you should keep these points in mind. All right. So first, wherever in life, this is a basic fundamental point for all the applicants, wherever in life. Okay. Research the mission statement of the company where you are applying. Okay. What they are looking for in an employee. Please research this. Tailor your CV accordingly, like a resume. Okay. Check the company page for specific details that you may include in your CV. These two are very important things. Okay. Now, list all the necessary points somewhere. Okay. In your notebook, maybe. Brainstorm and find details, find ideas, and be as precise as you can. Okay. Keep it no more than 2 pages. Okay. Front back mat use karna. Use 2 separate A4 sheets. Okay, it gives a greater effect. It gives a greater impression. Always remember that your CV is your impression, and the first impression is always the last impression. Okay, So also keep it grammatically flawless. Okay, it makes a very good impression on the employer. Okay, please know that there are no set formats of creating a CV, but there is a set sequence. Okay, don't tell that I said that there is no format, so idhar ka cheez udhar kar diya and you all mess it up. Okay, then you blame it on me. Okay, it is not like that. You have to keep the sequence intact. And lastly, you need to be honest, okay? Otherwise, you may be sued, okay, or legally prosecuted by the company. So guys, this is how the basic format of a CV should be, okay? You can alter the style of presentation, but please do not alter the sequence, okay? I'm warning you time and again, do not alter the sequence of CV, okay? So the first thing is your personal details, okay? Name, address, phone number, and email, okay? Do not go to write the such name, Rishav Rivude, address, this, phone number, this. Just straight away write your name, your address, your phone number, and your email, okay? It can be placed either on the left hand side or on the center of the page. Please do not put it on the right hand side, okay? Put a gap of two lines and after that write your aim. Why are you writing the CV? Okay, so a sample aim can be to find a suitable job based on my niche, okay, based on my preferences and my qualifications, okay? After that, another gap of two lines, and then you have to state your educational qualifications, okay, for your school, your high school, your college, or you can include MA, PhD, etc. Okay, so the format goes like this: I studied in Doon School in Humanities Division from this year to this year, and I got, for say example, 90% marks. Okay, so this should be the format of writing your educational qualifications. If you have acquired any other qualifications, do mention it, but only after you have done your educational qualifications. For example, if you have a diploma in computer, okay, so you can include this here. But do not include anything other than professional qualifications. Okay, a gap of two lines, which is followed by the working experience. Okay, so if you have any work experience, please mention it here. And please include only two, but the most prominent and the most impressive ones. Okay, so this is the format. As a post, for example, manager. As a manager in company TCS from this to this, okay? So this should be the format of writing a work experience. Please do not include this expected salary quote, okay? It is very old fashioned. Like, I expect a salary of 4 lakhs, 5 lakhs, 1 crore, whatever it may be, okay? Please do not include this. This does not generally leave a very good impression, okay? A gap of two lines again, and then the most scoring thing in the CV, okay? Hobbies and interests. So include each one, okay? So the hobbies can be like collecting coins, collecting stamps, okay, doing yoga, composing music, and your interests, please pay attention, can be, okay, I am interested in rural development, I am interested in environment and ecology, okay, I am interested in animal conservation, okay, these are your interests. So please mention them, please keep them honest, and please keep them professional, so that if you are asked in the interview, you can always say about it, okay. If you have got any awards, okay, or if you have got any special accomplishments, okay, that can really make your CV dazzle, okay, so you can use them If you have any associations, for example, if you are associated with the Rotary Club, with the Lion Club, with an animal club, okay. So these things should be mentioned in a CV, okay. So now this is the most important part. Most candidates get rejected because they do not mention the references. Okay, please mention these references. Okay, so you have to mention only two references, not more than that, not less than that. Okay, so the format should be the name of the reference, okay, and the post. For example, if he or she is an assistant professor at an university, so that is the post. Okay, so you have to mention the post, you have to mention his or her address and phone and email for contacting purposes. Okay, so at the end there is a declaration, so the declaration will be as such: the above stated facts are true to my knowledge. Okay, after that give the date. Try to use the American format of the date. Please look up on the internet what is an American system. Okay, and lastly please include your signature. Okay, so that's all. So guys, do you want me to make more courses on writing skills? Please write it in the comment section. Also rate, review and share. Thank you so much.